Hello and welcome you all to my video lecture classes of production technology. In my previous videos, we just started the another topic which is named as your powder metallurgy. In these videos, we already discussed about your manufacturing of powder. So let us discuss about the basic steps in powder metallurgy and about the process description. In powder metallurgy, the articles are produced by pressure and heat. Usually, the pressure and heating stages are separate and are termed as compacting and sintering stages respectively. The compacting is also called briquetting or compressing. Powder metallurgy process usually involve a series of steps. Number one, here it is written, production of powder or powder production, or you can say the manufacturing of powders. Next, blending operation. Number three, compacting operation. Number four, sintering, and it is subsequently subdivided into pre-sintering, then sintering, and finishing operation. And this finishing operation is again subdivided into some secondary process like sizing, machining, plating, and heat treatment, etc., are also involved in this process. In powder metallurgy, first, the composed of specially selected and prepared powders is specially sintered paper is compressed in a dies under pressure. After that, the half finish gets strengthened by a result of high temperature treatment sintering, which is conducted at a temperature below the melting point of the basic metal which goes into the mixture. That means from 66% to 75% of the melting point. As a result of this technique, the particles in powder materials are always in contact with each other. The increase of contact area can be accomplished by changing the shape of the particles by the action of external forces, that is, by pressing and sizing, or by drawing the atoms in the metal towards the contact regions. Is a phenomenon which is caused by the movement of atoms at an evaluated temperature is known as sintering. As a result of the increase in contact surface, the strength of the object is increases. The contact surface of bodies is defined as the size of the contact area of continuous particles separated by distance less than the range of molecular force. So this is all about the whole process description of powder metallurgy technique. So again, we'll discuss one by one. The first process in powder metallurgy technique is the manufacturing of powder, which is already we discuss in my previous videos, or you can say part one. Let us discuss about the next process, which is then, or I can say next step in powder metallurgy, that is so called blending metal powders. After the manufacturing of the powder, metal parts is in mixture or blending is taken place. Blending is so called mixing is the next step in powder metallurgy process, must be carried out under controlled condition to avoid contamination and deterioration. Deterioration is caused by excessive mixing and causes the shape to be altered or the particles harden, causing the compacting process to be difficult. Is done for several significant reasons. This blended of the powders actually determine many difficult properties that can be obtained. Many combination of the metals are of metals with ceramics or other materials that can be used as melting alloys or can be possible. The mixing may be done either in wet or dry condition, and an efficient mixture is used to produce a homogeneous mixture. So you can see the various reasons for which we do this important, and it is having very impact value which determines the property of a blend component. So the blending reason for blendings are to impart special physical and mechanical properties and characteristics. Proper mixing is essential to ensure the uniformity of mechanical properties throughout the part. Even one metal can be powder vary in size and shape. The ideal mix is one in which all the particles of each material are distributed uniformly. Lubricants can be mixed with the powders to improve flow of metal powder into dyes, reducing friction between the metal particles and improve the dye life. Otherwise, scratches may be formed inside the dye. Binders are used to develop sufficient grain strength, and the objective can be used to facilitate sintering. So this is all about your operation, which is known as blending of metal powders. So let us discuss about the next operation, which is known as your compaction of metal powder, or you can say in short form compacting, and in some books it is also written as briquetting. Compacting or briquetting is the process of converting loose powder into a grain compact, as it is called, of accurately defined size and shape. The compacting stages is carried out generally at room temperature in a dice by using a die set upon an press machine. The die consists of a cavity. The shape of the desired part must be formed two to ten times deeper according to the material to be handled. Material powder is poured into the cavity and level of the flask with the top of this die. The third step here it is written. Then the next is the plunger usually work from the top and the bottom of the die. The dies are forced together under high pressure into the die cavity, and the powder is compressed to the desired shape to 1/3 approximately of its original volume. Dies are made usually of high grade steel, finally finished and hardened. The process used for compacting may be either mechanical or your hydraulic. Generally, nowadays we are using hydraulic presses for this operation. Here you can see in this figure, this is the plunger, or you can say the upper punch, and this is the lower punch. So first of all, this is goes up, and we pour the metal powder into it. This green color is a metal feeding. Thereafter, with the help of this both die here, we are applying pressure in this is the ejector operation. Here we are applying this. The blue color is your powder, and it is accomplished here. So these powders are pressed in between this die by using a upper punch and a lower punch. So finally, with the help of the lower punch, after pressing operation, this green compact is come out. And here the third figure, it shows the ejection of the green compact. And this here it is written, and this green compact is now ready for the next operation, which is known as your sintering operation. So this is known as green compact. And in my next video, we will discuss about the next powder metallurgy technique, which is named as sintering. Thank you.